God is a wonderful God. He woke us up early this morning.
Yes, sir.
Started us on our way.
Yes.
Put walking in our step, talking in our mouth, seeing in our eyes, hearing in our ears. God's a wonderful God.
Yeah.
He's wonderful to me.
Amen.
He's a wonderful Savior to me. I don't know about you.
Yeah.
But I love Him. Oh, I love Jesus.
Amen.
Yes. Help us, Lord. Help us.
He's the one.
Yes, sir.
That we need to come running. Go running to, rather.
Yes.
Peter asked the way, Lord, to whom shall we go?
Yes.
Thou hast the words to eternal life.
Yes.
We need to go to a man that's got eternal life.
Yes, sir.
And if you're sick, Brother Smith, if you're sick and you can't get well, just call upon the Lord.
Yes, sir.
There's nobody else you can call on.
Yeah.
You might call on me when you get sick, but I can't do nothing for you.
Yeah.
But be there.
Yeah.
But Jesus can not only be there, He can heal your body.
Yes. Amen.
Heal your troubled mind.
Yeah.
I don't care what you're going through. God is up to the occasion and He can handle it.
Yes,
He can handle it.
Oh, yes.
There's no situation that God can't handle.
Oh,
nothing in this world that God cannot handle.
Amen.
Jesus said, all power is given unto me.
Yes, sir.
In heaven and in earth.
All right.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You got all power. You don't have to worry about it.
Yeah.
Am I right or wrong?
Amen.
That's why He could go to the grave when Lazarus got sick.
Yes.
His sister said, Lord, if you had been here, my brother wouldn't have died.
Right.
Let me tell you something. God will lift you down and still come and raise you up.
Amen.
It doesn't make any difference whether you've been here or not.
Yes.
Jesus can still do what He could have done if He had been there.
Yes.
If He hadn't been there, He could still raise
you. Yes. Beautiful.
Raise Brother Doug, just be one, but I let him lay there, Lord. He worked too hard. Let him lay there. I don't want you to raise him, Lord. Let him go on home and rest.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't want you to raise him.
Yes, sir.
Brother Douglas worked hard enough. For me, now maybe not for God, but I know he was a good worker.
Yeah.
Am I right about
Amen.
It? That's what God wants us to do. God wants us to work until we can't work anymore.
Amen.
Am I right about
Amen.
It? Paul told the Corinthians, be ye steadfast.
Yes.
Unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord.
Okay.
I don't want no part-time Christian.
Yeah.
I want full-time. Always.
Yeah.
Not part-time, ladies and gentlemen. That's full-time.
All right.
Yes,
ain't nothing wrong with a part-time job if you're trying to survive and struggling.
Yeah.
Am I right about it?
All right.
I've been struggling. I've been straining.
Yeah.
But I'm on my way home.
All right.
Thank you, Lord. For blessing us to just be here this morning. I thank you for this opportunity, Brother Smith. And I thank you all for being here this morning.
Yes.
God is good. We might act like he cuts us short sometime, but He never cut us short.
No, amen.
God is a long-suffering God.
Yes.
Am I right about that?
Amen.
Peter said it like this, 1 Peter 3:9. God is not slack concerning His promise.
Yes, sir.
But is long-suffering toward us.
Yes.
Not willing that any should perish, but that all should come unto repentance.
All right, preach.
God wants everybody to straighten up. Am I right?
Yes.
And fly right. My daddy used to straighten up and fly right.
Yes.
God wants us all to straighten up and fly right.
All right.
Right. That's why I said all should come unto repentance.
Yes.
You know, a lot of people act like they don't need to repent, but God say you do.
Yeah.
God said, Paul told a Romans 3:23, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Yeah. Right.
Then when I go to Ecclesians 7:21, the Bible said that none that do good and sin not.
Yeah.
Everybody's come short.
Okay.
I know Zacchaeus was a little short man, but we just about as short as he is when it comes to sin. When it comes to Rome, we're just about as short as Zacchaeus. So we've all messed up. We need to clean up
when
we messed up.
Yes, sir.
Start our life over again.
Yeah, all right.
Ain't that right? We need to clean up. Some people act like they ain't messed up nothing, but you messed up some stuff.
Yeah.
You need to clean up.
Yeah.
I made up my mind. I ain't lying no more. I'm going back to church. Going to walk right through the door.
All right.
I got to clean up.
Yeah, all right.
Clean up.
All right, Brother Turner.
Yeah, we messed up.
Oh, you preaching,
like we messed up, but we have.
Amen.
You know, some people act like I'm holier than thou. Let me tell you something. You've been slipping on something.
Yeah.
I don't know whether it's a banana peeling or apple peeling, but you've been slipping on something. You slipped some kind of way.
Yeah.
But anyway, Lord have mercy. I better move on. I thank you.
Amen.
Brother Smith for this opportunity. Thank him for leading us in our singing.
Amen.
And thank his brother for the wonderful job that he's done in serving us around the table and election and communion.
Yes.
And thank you for just being here.
Amen.
God wants us all to assemble. Am I right about
that? Amen.
Hebrews 10:24 says, provoking one another to love and good works.
Yes, sir.
Forsaking not the assembly of yourselves, what? Together.
Yeah.
If we're going to assemble, let's do it together.
All right.
Not just let me come here by myself. Come with me.
Amen. Yeah.
That's together.
Amen.
Lord have mercy. I need you here with me.
Amen.
I need some comfort. I need some encouragement.
Yes, sir.
I need some love.
Yeah.
I need some provoking.
Yeah,
many times I get weak. I need somebody to provoke me to love. Lord have mercy. Not hate. Provoke me to love.
Amen.
I like loving folk. I don't like being mean to folk and being that's one thing about I can say about my brother. He was a loving man.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He was a Christian man.
Amen.
My brother was a good man. And you know what? I learned a lot of things from my brother.
Yeah.
The Bible says he has the salt of the earth.
Yes.
Good influence. My brother had good influence. Salt is good influence. Yeah. Every house you go by, I'll have a little salt in there.
Amen.
I know you got a little salt in your kitchen somewhere.
Yeah.
You need some influence. You need some salt in your life. Influence.
Yes.
Everybody need a little influence. Something to influence their life.
Okay. Yeah.
My brother had a lot of influence. He had some good influence, Brother Smith, and he had some bad influence.
Okay.
But anyway, you look at it, he had exerted influence.
All right.
He had influence.
Amen.
One day, let me tell you this, and I'm going to move on. One day, I know he had influence. One day, I let him use my old car. I had an old 67 Chevy. You remember them old 67 Chevys?
Yeah.
Chevelle.
Yeah.
And I let my brother use it, you know. And here he go, racing up down Ferris Street in my little, man, I was proud of that little car. It was sweet. 396, Brother Smith.
That's
real, real sweet.
Yeah.
Man, he's down to that full speed. He's going through the gear.
Yeah.
And messed around and got up a little bit too high and lost control of my car. Lord have mercy.
Yeah.
That really hurt me. That was a bad influence. That was bad influence. That really hurt me, man. But you know what? I got over it. We never had an argument. One thing I can say about me and my brother, we never had an argument.
That's good.
We didn't always agree on things, but we never fought, we never had argument.
Amen.
Lord, we got along perfectly.
Amen.
Perfectly for brothers.
Yeah.
You know, to stay in a house with a brother, it's hard to stay in a house with a brother and not have some kind of complication. Am I right about that? Even a husband and wife, hard for them to live in one house and not have complications.
All right.
But that's part of living.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You're going to have some problems. But we're going to move on. Our time is limited, so let's go back to our text. Brother James has read this text wonderfully. Luke, the 8th chapter, and verse number 43 will commence. Be good to have Shannon, my son, with us this morning.
Amen.
Thank God for him. And I invited some more, but you know, it's hard for people to get up at, say, 8 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
On Sunday especially. You know, they get up, some will get up and go to work. Some of them won't even do that.
Yeah.
You got some young men laying out all day if you support them. Don't do a thing. Hard for them to get up and watch their face. My blood going to work. Oh, that hurts. But anyway, it's hard for some people on Sunday morning.
Yeah.
But anyway, Luke verse 46. And a woman having an issue of blood 12 years, you can underline that 12 years if you want, which had spent all of her living, you can underline all this, upon physician, neither could be healed of him. Came behind him, you can underline that, came behind him and touched the border of his garment. And immediately, I like that word immediately.
Yeah.
And immediately her issue of blood stenched, which means it stopped. Mm-hmm. Okay? And Jesus said, who touched me? When all denied Peter and they that were with him said, Master, the multitude thronged thee and pressed thee, and sayest thou, who touched me?
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus said, somebody had touched me.
Mm-hmm.
For I perceive that virtue, goodness, that's virtue,
yeah,
is gone out of me.
Yeah.
And when the woman, this is what I like, and when the woman saw that she was not healed, she came trembling, falling down before him, and declared unto him before all the people for what cause she had touched him and how she was healed immediately.
All right.
And he, watch this now, and he said unto her, daughter, be of good comfort. Thou faith.
Amen.
Thou faith. I'm going to emphasize this now.
Yeah.
Thou
all right.
faith.
Mm-hmm.
Thou faith.
All now. Right, preacher.
Thou faith had made thee whole. What yeah. made her whole?
Faith.
Faith. What's going to make you whole? Your
faith.
What's going to take away your problem?
Your faith. Yes,
what's
sir.
What's going to get you out of misery?
All your right. Your faith. Yes,
what's
sir.
What's going to keep people from giving you trouble?
Faith. Yes, sir.
What's going to get you to heaven? Your
faith. Yes, sir.
What's going to get you from, Lord have mercy, earth to glory? Your
faith.
Faith.
Yes, sir.
Faith is what's going to get you. If you want to get to heaven, you got to have some faith.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's why Jesus said you believe in God, John the 14th chapter.
Yeah.
He said, you believe in God, believe also in me.
Yes.
In my Father's house for many
mansions. Yes, sir.
If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place. Lord have mercy.
Yes.
I like prepared places.
Yes.
I don't like to go to a place if it's not prepared.
All right, right, all right.
If I go eat, I want to go to a prepared place.
Yes.
Wherever I go, I want to go where it's prepared.
All right, preacher.
I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, this is the shouting part.
Yeah.
And prepare a place for you, I will. Not I might.
All right.
I will come again.
Yes, preach, preacher.
And not only will I come, I'll receive you unto me.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's where I am.
You may
I don't
be
know
awesome.
About you.
Yes.
I want to be where the Lord is.
All right, preacher.
On Sunday, I want to be where the Lord is.
Amen. Amen.
On Monday, I want to be where God is.
All right, preacher.
Tuesday, I want to be where God is.
Yeah.
Wednesday, I want to be where God is.
All right, preacher.
Thursday, I want to be where God is.
Yeah.
Friday, I want to be where God is. Yeah. Sunday, morning.
All right, preacher.
I want to be where God is.
All right, all right.
Yeah. Yeah. On them where God is, everything going to be all right.
All right.
It won't be nothing but a party when I'm with where God is.
Yes.
God's got everything prepared.
All right.
That's why I want to be where God is.
Amen.
Everything is all right.
Amen.
I don't care how much hell I'm catching in this world, as long as I got God by my side.
Yeah,
God.
Yeah.
Woman.
Yes, sir.
Wanted
yes, sir.
To be where God was.
Yes.
She come up behind.
Yes. Yes.
Come down. Yes. If you want to make it to heaven, you're going to have to make a come from behind.
Yes.
The marriage win game, sometimes they have to come from behind.
All right, preacher.
You can't win sometimes without coming from behind.
Yeah.
Yeah, you have to look at 44. Says she came behind him. Am I right about it?
All right.
And she touched him with his gum.
Yeah.
And immediately, Lord have mercy.
Yes.
When you touch God.
Yeah, it's
and touch him in faith.
All right.
Healing.
Yes, yes.
Right,
all right.
You don't have to wait until Sunday morning. God can make it happen on Monday.
All right.
He can make it happen on Tuesday.
Yeah.
If you come in faith to God.
Amen.
You have to come with your faith game.
Yes.
Yeah, you have to come with your faith game.
Oh, yes.
And a woman had it in your blood. Look how long she had it. She had it 12 years. Man, that's a long time to be in trouble. That's a long time to be sick. 12 years. Brother Douglas was sick 5 years. Am I right about it? He was unable to walk 5 years. But thank God yesterday, God fixed it for him.
All right.
He went on to heaven. I know he went on to heaven because God with him. Am I right about it? He had to come from behind, but he made it. Am I right about it?
All right.
Please do not use the swift, not a balance, and a stone.
Yes.
But the one that endure to the end.
Yes, sir.
You ask not how you start in life.
All right, preacher.
You got to finish. You got to finish strong.
All right.
Stay with God.
Amen.
God's a good God. But he wants to keep things with him. Am I right? Jesus said it like this in Matthew 16:24. If any man will come after me,
and
deny himself, take up his cross, follow me. God wants us to follow him, not the world, but follow me.
A
lot of folk want to follow the world.
Yeah.
God don't want to follow the world. He wants to follow him. Because the world is not going anywhere. Am I right about it?
Amen.
The world is headed to destruction, but God is headed to heaven. Lord, have mercy. We got to watch what we do.
There's
a woman that had an issue of blood 12 years. And what's bad about it is the woman that went around from doctor to doctor. She went from Parkland to Baylor. From Baylor to Presbyterian. That went from Presbyterian.
Been everywhere.
Medical arts. Medical arts. She went out to even Scottish White. Trying to get healed. She went to Dr. Smith. She went to Dr. Terrell. She went to Dr. Smith. She went to Dr. Sheldon. But none of us could heal.
All right.
But when she come in contact with Jesus, Lord have mercy. Sometimes we run to the wrong place.
That's it, preacher.
You need to go to Jesus if you got a problem.
Amen.
Especially if it's a spiritual or a health problem. God can fix it all.
Amen.
Just that I've come.
Yes.
That they might have life.
Yes, sir.
That they might have it. Save me from my sickness.
All right.
Save me from
Preach,
my sickness.
Preach,
Scotty. Save me from everything in this world that bothers me and hinders me.
Yes.
Lord,
have
mercy.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
A little bit further here.
Yes,
she spent all of her living upon physician. Neither could be healed of any. There wasn't a doctor around that could heal this woman.
Yeah.
I thank God that this woman of the determination, God.
She
was a determined God. The Bible says she pressed
Yeah.
to see Jesus. That let me know she was determined.
All right.
She was desperate. Am I right about
it?
Can't do nothing sometime until you get desperate.
All right.
Desperate, you do it.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. When you get real hungry, you get up and find yourself. Desperate. You get up and go to work when you get hungry. Am I right about it? Desperate. Either that or you start stealing.
Lord
have mercy. And when you look at it, when you get desperate, you do something.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
This woman was desperate.
Yes.
She was a desperate woman, Shepherd.
Yes.
So when you get desperate, let me tell you something. You'll go out and find your job.
Amen.
Not only will you find your job, you'll find your 9 to 5.
All right.
There won't be no part-time. You'll find your 9 to 5. Something that you know will support you.
Yes.
You find something that you put a roof over your head.
Yeah.
All right.
Sometimes these little handouts won't put a roof over your head. Yeah. But if you get a job.
Yes, sir.
Lord have mercy.
Oh, yes.
This woman had a job. Her job was to get to Jesus.
All right.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
Look at Let's look at this woman real closely, y'all. I'm gonna let you go in a minute.
Yeah.
I'm gonna let you go. And a woman having an issue. Let me deal with that issue a minute. You know, a lot of times we act like we don't have some issues. Am I right about it? Am I right about it? Sometimes we act like we don't have no issues. Let me tell you something. As long as you're in this world, you got one issue.
All right.
You got at least one issue. Am I right about it? But you know what? Thank God that we got a God that can help us get rid of our
issues. All right, that's it. That's it. That's it, bro.
Charles. He's the issue solved.
Yes.
Am I right about it?
All
he's
right.
a mind regulator.
All right.
Yes.
Yeah, he can solve all our issues. See, some of our issues are in the mind. It's not really in sickness.
Amen.
Somebody, can I get an amen?
Amen.
Some of our issues are in our mind.
Yes, sir.
Yes, that's right. Amen.
Amen.
You can say amen if you can.
Amen.
Some of our issues are up here.
Yes.
Brother Smith, I see where he preaches from a checkup from the neck up. Sometimes we need a checkup from our neck up.
All right. Yes. You're right.
Amen.
Instead of looking around at other folk, we need to look inside.
Yes,
go out.
All right, preacher.
We're looking out the window and start peeking in the house. Trouble is in the house. It ain't out there in somebody else's yard. Sweep around your own front door.
All right.
Get your broom before you go sweeping around mine. Everybody need a broom.
Amen.
Everybody get their own broom. They won't have to worry about sweeping around them.
Yeah.
Lord have mercy.
Yes.
Look here. She kept 44. She came behind and she touched border. She didn't try to take his belt off. She didn't try to pick off his belt. All she wanted to do was just get a little bitty touch of the border.
Alright.
That's a touch of faith. You don't have to have a lot of faith.
All
Jesus
right.
said if you have the faith of a grain of mustard seed,
yes, sir.
You can say to the mountain, go
all
out.
Right.
And it'll move itself.
Amen.
God, all you need is a little faith.
Yes.
But a big God. We serve a big God, so you don't need much faith. Just put the little you got to work.
Amen.
Lord have mercy. She came behind. She touched the border of his garment, and immediately. Lord have mercy.
Now, immediately.
If you've been sick 12 years,
yeah.
You done deal with this thing 12 years, man. Okay, can you imagine how happy this woman was immediately?
Amen. Yeah.
Lord have mercy. You've been going through some stuff 12 years, a bunch of stuff that just killing you.
Yes.
Destroying you.
Yes. All right.
Messing up your mind.
Yeah.
Messing up your health.
Yeah. Okay.
Breaking up your relationship with folk.
Yeah.
People can't stand you.
Mm-hmm.
People don't want to come around you.
Okay,
this
preacher.
Woman was isolated from society. Nobody could sit where she sit. No. Nobody could lay where she laid. The
all
woman
right.
was isolated.
Yes.
12 years.
All right, preacher.
12 years.
Yes, sir.
So she got to talking to herself.
Yeah.
Lord, if I can just touch.
Yes.
Y'all get out the way.
Yeah.
Y'all get out the way. I know it's a crowd here, but y'all get back.
Yeah.
I got to get to Jesus.
Yeah.
She went to using crowd psychology.
Yeah.
Y'all get back now. I got to get to Jesus.
Yeah.
I know there's a lot of folk here, but I got to get to Jesus.
Okay.
I know people don't like me, but I got to get to Jesus.
Okay.
I know folk hate me. I know they don't want to see me get there, but I got to get there. Y'all move back.
All right.
Amen.
Sometimes you have to step over folk to get to Jesus.
All right,
preacher. Sometimes you have to let folk down.
Yes.
To get to Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes you have to disappoint folk
okay.
in order to get to Jesus.
All right.
Sometimes you have to ignore some stuff.
All right,
in
preacher.
Order to get to Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes you have to give up some things.
All right,
in order
that's
to
it.
Get to Jesus.
Yes.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes you have to let it go.
Yeah, let it go.
To get to Jesus.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because let me tell you, some folk was hinder you.
Yeah.
To get to Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah. I said, well, that was Hillside, the little church. Let's not let folks stop us from getting to Jesus.
All right, that's it, preacher.
Hey, Brumley, you mean that was Hillside Church of Christ? Yes, it is. And we're not going to stop you from letting us get to Jesus.
All right.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We might be small in membership.
Yeah.
But we can get to Jesus.
Yeah.
All right.
Amen.
Like this woman, and we can get to Jesus.
All right.
I got to get to
to it.
Yes, gotta get to it.
I got to get to it.
Yes, sir.
Because I know if I get to it.
Yes, sir.
Immediately.
All right, that's it.
Immediately.
Yes.
Can be solved.
All right, that's it.
I've been down for a year.
Yeah.
I got to get to Jesus.
Amen.
Folks been holding me back 12 years.
Yes, sir.
Problems been holding me back 12 years.
All right.
But I can't let it stop me no more.
All right.
If I can just turn.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Oh, right now.
Yeah.
There are songs been put out by, if I can touch the hem of his garment.
Yes, sir.
Horns. If I can touch the hem of his garment.
Okay.
But this woman was a reality.
Yes.
Reality was, if I can get through this crowd.
Yeah, yeah.
And get to Jesus.
Yes.
I know everything will be all right.
All right.
I'm out of
heaven. Amen.
Yes, sir. Let me make a couple more points in there.
Preach.
And verse 45. And Jesus said, I like that too. Who touched me? It's not that Jesus didn't know who touched him.
Yeah.
He knew that somebody touched him.
All right.
You don't have to worry about who touched you.
Yeah.
When it's something good done. Don't worry about who did it. Am I right about
it? Amen.
When we hear something on the news, we worry about who did it. Am I right about it? Who's responsible?
Yeah.
Well, this woman was responsible herself.
Yes.
For getting herself to Jesus. Sometimes you can't depend on other folk.
Yes.
To get you to Jesus.
Yes. Amen.
Sometimes you got to get up.
Yeah.
And do it yourself.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You remember with the man that laid by the pool.
Yeah.
38 years.
All right, preacher.
Came to the pool.
Uh-huh.
And the man was laying there.
Yeah.
And the man said, I have no man
to
put me in the pool.
Yeah.
Jesus said, do you want to be
saved? Yeah.
If you want to be made whole.
Yeah.
If you want to be, just get on up. You've been laying there. You've been making excuses. You've been lazy.
Yeah.
You just didn't want to get to the pool.
Yeah.
You could have been and rolled yourself over in that banana. Am I glad about it? I could have been and crawled to the pool long as it been laying there.
Yeah.
All right.
But Jesus asked him, say, do you want to be? Lord have mercy. That's all God is asking us.
Yeah.
Do you want to be saved?
Yes.
Do you want this issue removed?
Yes.
Do you want it?
Yes.
God wants to know, do you want to be
Amen.
Yes.
Am I right about it?
All right.
Don't worry about what other folk want. Do you?
Yes.
Personally, do you want to be made whole?
Amen, yes. Preacher.
Lord have mercy.
Have mercy.
If you want something, you can get up and get it.
Yes.
All power.
All power.
Yes.
God has the power.
Absolutely.
And Jesus said, who touched me? What? Okay. Watch it. When all denied.
Uh-huh.
That's what I like about old Peter. Look at old Peter.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 45, Brother Smith, go there with me. I'm going to leave you alone. I just want you to read that one today. Don't have you reading yourself to death today.
Right.
I just want you to look at that one. That one verse.
Verse 45.
Yes, 45.
And Jesus said, who touched me?
Who touched me?
When all had denied.
All right.
And Peter and they
that were with him.
Say,
they said,
master.
What did they say? They said, Master, I'm glad they called him Master.
All right.
I read about it. Let me tell you something. Jesus ought to be your master.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Yes. Amen.
If you want to be saved, you're going to have to let God be your master.
All right.
As long as you let God be your master, not the devil, you got the right master.
All right, preacher. That's
it. You got the right master.
Amen.
Sometimes we let money master us.
All right.
Sometimes we let prestige master us.
All right, that's
sometimes
true.
Sometimes we let clothes master
all
us.
All right, preach.
Sometimes we let our job master
okay.
us.
Okay, all
sometimes
right.
Sometimes we let our friend master us.
Yeah.
So Jesus ought to be your master.
Yes.
Amen.
Your master. Priority.
Yes.
Let's get our priorities straight.
Yes.
Matthew 6:33, Jesus said, seek ye first what?
The kingdom of heaven.
All right.
And all of his righteousness.
Yes.
And all these things shall be added what? Unto you.
Yes.
That's all you got to do is put God first. Let him be your master.
Amen.
Yeah. Let him be your master and everything will be all right.
Yeah.
I'm glad that bed wasn't your master this morning.
Amen.
I'm glad going to be at home wasn't your master.
Yes, sir.
I'm glad that just selfishness wasn't your master.
Yeah.
I'm glad to let God use you. you this morning.
All right, yes. Preacher.
Amen.
If you see, you got to let God use you.
Amen.
Am I right about it?
Amen.
Amen.
That's what church folks do. Am I right about it?
Yes.
We need to do what church folks do.
Yes.
What the church folks do, they let God use them.
Yes.
Glory to mercy.
Preach. Preach.
Y'all all right?
Amen.
Amen.
Am I going to be good?
Amen.
Just a little bit. A little bit more. Read on, Brother Smith. Verse 45.
Yes, a multitude throng. The multitudes throng thee.
In other words, the multitudes all around you, Lord.
Yeah.
Read.
Press thee.
And they press. They cried at you. They pressed you. They cried at you.
And thou sayest thou, who touched me?
And you say, look, you've seen all these multitude of folks, Jesus. You've seen them coming at towards you.
Everybody
and you're going to ask me, who touched me?
Yeah.
And of the crowd, any one of us could have touched you. But I'm glad everybody that touched
you.
The woman with the trouble was the one that touched you.
All right, preacher,
that
that's
the
it.
The one that needed to touch
all right, that's
other
it.
Other folks don't need to touch you.
All right.
There's some folks in the world that's got trouble need to touch Jesus.
Yeah. That's it.
They need to touch you. That's some folks with some real issues.
Yes.
They need to touch Jesus.
Yes.
And Jesus need to touch them.
Yes.
Read on a little bit further. I'm quitting in a minute.
And Jesus said.
That's what I like about it.
Touched me.
He said somebody. I'm glad he said somebody. He didn't say everybody.
All right.
Somebody touched me.
Yes.
I'm glad that somebody was the woman that deserved.
Amen.
To be touched by Jesus.
All right.
You see, some folks deserve to be touched by the Lord and some don't.
All right.
Why do you say that, preacher? Because some will not trust in God.
Yes. All right.
They won't obey and they won't trust him.
Yes, sir.
You got to obey him and trust him if you want to be touched by Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Am I right about it?
Amen.
You got to apply to his will.
Yes.
Apply to his will.
Yes.
Bible said, Hebrews 8. I believe it 8:6. Though he was a son, yet learned he obedience by the things which he suffered.
Uh-huh.
And being made perfect, he became the author of eternal salvation.
All right.
To all them.
Yeah.
I like that word.
Yeah.
To all them that obey him.
Yes.
All right about it.
Yes.
You got to obey the Lord if you want God to touch you.
All right, that's it.
If you want your salvation. Authorized.
All right.
Smith, when you go to work, you want somebody to authorize your check, don't
all
you?
Right.
Well, same thing when it comes to Christianity.
Preach, preacher.
When it comes to salvation,
yeah.
I want Jesus to authorize.
Yes, sir.
Salvation.
Yes.
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 Beautiful.
Jesus authorized it. I know I got it all right.
Yeah.
Okay.
I know my check's good.
Yeah.
When Jesus signed my check,
all right.
Yeah.
When Jesus signed it, I know it's all right.
Yeah, okay.
I know I can go to American Bank of America and cash it. I know I can go to Chase Bank if I want to.
Yeah.
I don't know what your bank is, but I can go to your bank and cash it off. Jesus got the
right. Yeah.
Everything is all right.
Yeah.
All right.
Beautiful.
It's all right.
Amen.
I got to get ready quick.
Yeah.
Let's look at one more thing, Brother Smith. Keep on reading now. Verse 46.
I perceive that virtue, I can see.
Jesus said, I can see. I can feel.
Yeah, I can feel.
Yeah, when you perceive a thing, you can feel it.
Uh-huh.
I can feel that goodness, virtue.
Yes.
Jesus had the virtue, what? Knowledge.
Yeah.
I can feel knowledge leaving my body.
All right.
Add to your virtue. Knowledge, gentlemen, brotherly love. Y'all remember all that.
All right.
You have to add to your faith. This woman added some stuff to her faith.
Yeah, that's it.
Lord have mercy.
Preaching.
Lord have mercy. Read on, Brother Smith. I got to hurry up here. I got five. Give me 5 minutes, 2 minutes, whatever you can give me.
I perceive
that virtue is gone where?
Out of me.
Everybody, look at him. When something go out of you, there's something wrong.
Amen.
If you get a little cut and you see a little blood running out, you see it, you perceive it, you see it, you're going to get worried. Am I right about it? He said, I perceive virtue is going out of me. Read on.
And when the woman saw
that watch this. This is it. I'm going to drop the bomb right here. I'm going to drop the bomb. The message is going to be yours.
And the woman saw that she wasn't hid.
She came.
Let me tell you. Let me work with that just a minute. See, a lot of us try to hide from God. We do things and we try to hide it.
Okay.
It's all right to respect people, but we need to learn to respect God.
Amen.
It's best to not try to hide stuff than to hide with God.
Yeah.
He already sees it.
Amen. That's it.
Don't
preacher.
Try to hide from God. Yeah. That's why I'm Turner everywhere I go. I don't try to be no holy thou. I'm Turner.
Yeah.
I'm going to be me. I don't care where I am. I'm going to cut up. I'm going to act a fool. I'm going to have fun. If you don't want me to, just don't let me be in your mix. Dismiss me. If you don't want Turner to be Turner, dismiss me.
Because
I'm going to be me. I'm not trying to pretend. I'm just me.
Amen.
But I'm a true believer.
Amen.
I am a true believer now. But I like to have fun. I perceive that virtue gone out of my body. Go ahead, Brother Smith, real quickly.
She came trembling.
See, look, watch it.
She came trembling and fell down before him.
Now, see, that's humble. That's
yeah,
being
that's
humble.
It. Yes.
You ever seen, I'm going to say this, don't y'all get offended. You know, we used to have a lot of dogs. We had some male dogs and we had some girl dogs. What I like about the more male dogs, they come to you standing up wagging the tail. But I had one little girl dog. And that little girl dog, Brother Smith, when I call her, the little girl dog just lay down and go to crawling. She be wetting everywhere, but she be crawling to me. Little girl dog. That dog was real humble. And that's the way God wants us to be, trembling, humble.
Yeah.
That's what that trembling means, humble.
Yeah.
He said the devil trembles.
Yeah.
The devil even tremble when it comes to God. He better tremble.
All right.
He better tremble.
Amen.
The powerful God.
Yes.
Amen.
Everybody ought to tremble. The world ought to tremble.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Can't tremble. Read on, Brother Smith. I know that's a kind of bad illustration, but just go with it. Like I say, I'm turning. Like I say, I'm just turning. I don't mean no harm. That wasn't too good of an illustration, but I'm still turning, y'all. I ain't trying to hurt nobody.
Falling down before him.
Watch it. And trembling and falling down before him. That's a way of humbling us. And sometimes we ought to start falling instead of trying to stand up to Jesus.
All
Lord,
right.
I'm this, I'm that, Lord.
Yes.
Start humbling yourself.
Yes.
Think what I am.
Yes.
Even in prayer.
Yes.
Lord have mercy.
On your knees.
Lord have mercy. That's reverence, honor. God wants us to respect him, y'all.
Yes.
Amen.
He deserves our respect.
And he gonna get it.
Watch this. We go down to verse 44. Let's clean this thing up. Let me get out of here.
48.
Let me let y'all out of here. Yes, sir. 48. 48.
And he said unto her.
Watch this.
Dog.
First.
You have good comfort.
Look in. This woman, at one time, she wasn't able to be called daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Because she had some issues.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Huh? And our issues wouldn't let her go where the other people frequent. She couldn't get close to Jesus without coming from behind him. She had to kind of hide.
Yes.
She had to try to hide. That's why the Bible said when she saw, she wasn't hid.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes you have to try to hide to get to Jesus. That's okay if you got to hide to get to it.
Yeah.
Somebody said Nicodemus came to him by night. I don't know whether he was trying to hide it. That's just the time it was for him to go.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But look in, thank God he went to him at all.
Amen.
Thank God that he came to Jesus at all. That might have been by night, but that's okay. Go ahead, Brother Smith, real quick. Let me clean this up.
He said unto her, daughter.
He said, daughter.
Be of good comfort.
Lord have mercy. That's what God is saying to us. God is telling us, look, you got me on your side. Nationwide is on your side. Be of good comfort.
Yeah.
Okay.
Be of good comfort. I'm with you.
Yes.
I know you got a problem, but I'm still with you.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I know you're not perfect, but I'm still with you.
Okay.
I know it ain't no perfect church, ain't no perfect preachers, ain't no perfect deacons, ain't no perfect elders, but I'm with you.
Yes.
Be of good comfort. Just do what I ask you to do. Keep trying to get to me.
Amen.
I'm in heaven waiting on you. Keep trying to get to me.
Yes.
I got a prepared place up there for you. Keep trying.
Amen.
Lord have mercy. Daughter, be of good comfort.
Thy faith that made thee whole.
Look at your faith
have fixed it for you.
Yeah. Amen.
Your car been broke down a long time, but your faith has fixed it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Your faith has put a motor in it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Your faith got the transmission working right.
Mm-hmm.
Your faith got gas in it.
All right.
Your faith got oil in it.
Okay.
Your faith got tired on it.
Preach.
Keep
preach.
On trying to get to me.
All right. That's it.
Lord have mercy.
Either
one. And she was made whole. That whole, you know what that whole mean? She didn't have no more problems.
No more issues.
Mm-hmm.
Everything was complete. Everything was satisfied.
Yes.
When you satisfy God.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Amen.
Hebrew writer said, without faith, Hebrews 11:6, without faith it's impossible.
Yes, sir. That's
but
it.
But he coming to God must believe
yes.
that he is. And that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Constantly.
Right.
That diligent means constantly.
All right.
Seek him.
Yes. Yes.
The message is yours this morning. You've heard the word. You've heard the word. Acts 15:7. I believe it is. You must believe the word. Matthew 16:15. Repent of your sins. Luke 13:3, Luke 9, Luke 3:19, 1 Peter 3:21, and confess Matthew 10:32, Romans 10:9-10. Confess Jesus Christ to be the Son of God, which is the sweetest confession mortal tongue can make, and be willing to be buried with him in baptism. Acts 3:21, Acts 2:38. Matthew 28:19, I believe it is, 20. Oh, that's plenty of scriptures. I can go in Acts. I can go in Acts. Acts is a book of conversion. I can go there and talk to you all day about conversion, baptism. But that's all you got to do, basically, is just come to God and give him your heart. Give him your heart, and he will make you whole, like
Amen.
He did this woman.
Amen.
He'll make you old. Just come to him and give him your life.
Yes.
Give him your life. See, God has to live in you. Paul put it like this. Let me quote this real quick. Paul said in Galatians 2:20, I'm crucified with Christ.
Yes.
Nevertheless, I live.
Yes.
But it's not I that live, but it's Christ that lives where? In me.
Amen.
Long as Christ lives in you, you can make the journey.
Amen. Yeah. Amen.
Live in you.
Amen.
And as long as you let him live in you, you can make this journey.
Yes, sir.
That's the only way you're going to make it, is let Jesus live in you. In other words, you got to be under God's direction.
Amen.
As long as we're under God's direction, everything will be all right.
Yes.
The message is yours this morning while we stand to sing the Savior's invitation. I've gone just about too long, but anyway, I hope